So, hello everyone, welcome to OWASP DKD chapter. Today's talk will be on offensive analysis on Android applications. Let me introduce to our today's speaker, who is Raja Naguri. He is an IT security analyst at FIS Global and he is also a SYNAC Red Team member. He is also creator of Project NightAngle, which is a Docker image for pen testing, which is now open source and got listed in OWASP project list. So that's all from my side, sir. Over to you. Thank you.
Hello.
Yes.
Anubhav, please confirm, am I audible?
Yes, sir, you are.
Okay, cool. So welcome to all the attendees and just give me a second, please. Okay. So we are just going to start our today's talk on Android application penetration testing. So moving forward. Okay, so little brief about myself. So as Anubhav already said about me, but let me again introduce something which I want to discuss in this talk. So currently, as Anubhav said, that I'm currently contributing to the OWASP tool that is NightAngle, which is somehow a Docker image of the tools which is used at the time of penetration testing, and it is currently available on the OWASP project also, OWASP project tools list also. Moving forward, so in oh sorry, in today's discussion we will be going some learn about some kickoff resources of mobile VA and PT. What are the device requirements and tools requirement to start for Android application VA PT for the same. Little bit about concept of Android architectures and in the last, which is like which everyone wants, like practical implementation, that how we can proceed for VA PT of any of the application in Android. Okay, so for the resources, there are three great resources which is available over the internet. So the first one is Mobile Security Testing Guide, which will provide you a bit like start from the starting of any of the Android concept, and it will end up to the practical implementation, and all the logical and practical resources are over there. All the information will be provided on this guidebook. Let me show you this guidebook. Okay, let me share my screen so that it can be visible to each and everyone. Okay, so if you can see this guide, you will be providing some introduction of the mobile testing guides. So they will provide you what logical aspect of the practical implementation of each and everything, like local data storage, communication with the trust endpoints, what all the logical things that you have to get knowledge about the same, so that you can move further for doing VAPT with the proper guideline for the same. So if you can go further, you will provide all the mobile architecture, what exactly the architecture of Android is. Okay, so here you will provide each and every information about the same. Similarly, there are also two resources. The second one is OWASP Mobile Top 10, and the third one is Hacktricks. So this third one resource is also great resource. You will provide information about the app penetration testing and web penetration testing, and each of the like all the check marks that you have to follow, that you have to be take care of at the time of testing. Okay, for device requirement, I will suggest you can use Windows, you can use Kali Linux, you can use Parrot OS, MacBook, whatever suits you. Like your RAM will be 8 to 2 GB, which is quite enough to start with the same, and your SSD or drive storage will be 250 gigs, greater than 250 gigs. And for Android interface, you can use emulator if you don't have any physical device or rooted physical device. Or for emulators, you can use Android Studio, Memu emulator, Nox, BlueStacks, Genymotion. And if you want to use your physical device, then you can connect your USB, connect your Android device with the USB cable, and you can go with the same. Okay, for tools requirement, you have to install JDEX UI, APK tools, MobSF, Frida, Objection, Burpsuit. So these are the tools which we have to require at the time of testing, like for the static and dynamic part also. Okay, so moving further, let's discuss about the Android architecture. So for Android architecture, there are some levels for the same in that in order to install or run any of the application on the platform. So the first layer of this architecture is Linux kernel, which has like all the physical and hardwares installed or implemented for the same, so that if any of the application needs to use any of the resources, they can give the permission to the application and the application use the same. That hardware will be your audio, your keypad, your Bluetooth connectivity, your camera, your display, and even your USB port or Wi-Fi card, etc. And if we go to the hardware abstraction layer, so here you can you here these this these are the connectivity of your Linux kernel and the layer which is present in which is present next to the Linux server kernels. And this architecture is completely based on Linux, so you can perform each and every command on the Linux architecture. That's the commands you have run or use in the Linux platform. So moving further, there are some C, C++ libraries and Android runtime which may be required at the time of running any of the Android application. So next layer is Java API framework. So here you will provide some all the managers and all the content providers that required at the time of running of the application or using any of the services which may be required at the time of any of the runtime application. And our last or the first layer is system apps that may be required, like if you are using Truecaller or something, then they have added a functionality that you can call from the application itself. Same as if you want to use any of the if you want to use camera of your mobile phone, and if that application has the functionality for the same, then you can just access your camera and from the application itself. If you want to scan a QR code, then you can just open the camera or use the camera from that particular QR code scanner application, and you will be able to do the same. So it's a so basically it's a architecture, Android architecture, so that you which is used in this particular Android platform where you can run your application and use some predefined or user-defined functionalities for the same. Moving further, okay, so before jumping to the actual penetration testing process, let's discuss about some penetration testing process, like what will be the steps for the same, and then we will discuss about the steps for the mobile penetration testing. So in basic penetration testing, there are five phases for the same. Like first, if you select any of the target, then you have to gain or in some information about the same. So the first phase is reconnaissance. That may be active or passive, according to your requirement, according to your information or what exactly information you want. So in this phase, you have to gather information for the target. What if you are doing with if you are going with the passive reconnaissance, then you will be doing some research which from the information which is publicly available for that particular target. And next, if we go to the next phase, that is scanning and enumeration. So before attacking any going to attack on any of the target, you will be scan some of the flaws or some of the endpoints, or we can say some of the ports or some of the services which may which you think may be vulnerable or may be exploitable. Then you will be going to scan for the same in order to check like if that particular service is vulnerable or not. Like in the third phase, gaining access. Okay, now if you got that if you got the information that particular service which is running on that particular target is vulnerable to some extent, then you are trying to access or gain the access for the same. And luckily, if you got the access, then you will come to the fourth phase, that is maintaining access. And here you will try to exploit further in order to make any vulnerability valid. And then lastly, for obvious reasons, you will clear all your findings and all the payloads like tried on that particular target. You will clean that stuff and like close that particular access for the same. So it is completely a basic penetration testing which we always follows. But if we talk about mobile or mobile application PT, then there are four phases for the same. Okay, the first phase reconnaissance is same. Like for active and passive information gathering, you will be going to Play Store for passive for specifically for passive reconnaissance. You will be go to the Play Store, select for the application, go for the more information, and there you will get each and every information for that particular application. For an example, you are downloading and you are planning to attack on Uber application, right? According to the VDP. So you will go to their Play Store. You will search about the further information about the company which is provided on that page, Play Store page. You will go to the more application from Uber. You will check that these are the more application which is provided by the by the Uber or the organization itself. You will try to escalate many things and get all the information from the same. So here you are completing the passive reconnaissance. So after passive reconnaissance, you will going to the second phase, which is static analysis. So static analysis is nothing but analysis of code of that particular application. We will see in the few slides what exactly static analysis is, and then we'll jump to the third analysis third phase, that is dynamic analysis. And for the dynamic analysis, we have to change or manipulate each and every activity which is running in that particular application on runtime, so that we can check what exactly changes are done when we do some changes at the request side, and and how the application will behave after that. So like if we provide any changes which can create a disturbance in that particular APK, that might give us some information for in that particular session where the application is running. Okay, so the last phase is reporting. Again, we have to report the findings of that Android APK after all our static and dynamic analysis. So it's a basic or a brief idea about how we can proceed in Android mobile penetration testing process. Moving further, okay, so for Android, like before jumping into that particular practical implementation, I have to mention some of like two processes, that is static and dynamic. So there are two analysis for the same. For static, again we will extract that APK to the to the tools which provided on online, and then we'll search about any hard-coded things which is present in that particular application of in the code of that particular APK, and we'll try to find information about the key from the keywords itself, and then we'll jump to the dynamic analysis, and from dynamic analysis we'll try to change the activity which is running in this APK and try to find out what exactly we are looking for. Okay, so coming to the static analysis. Okay, so for static analysis, like for the Android, there is an extension called APK, which is somehow similar to .zip, which if we run in Linux machine. So for that, you will provide in that APK. If you extract that, you will be provided some of the file structure, which contains Android manifest.xml file. You will find a resources folder. You will find some XML folder which contains all the string files or all the XML files. And if you will provide classes.txt file. So these are the structure of Android APK dot APK file. And we will go into first analysis of doing analysis of Android manifest file. So for Android manifest file, its extension is XML dot XML. And in that file, so basically it's a main file of that APK, which gives the command to the APK to use the particular services from the Android device, or use the particular hardware, or use the particular permission, or if that APK wants to use the internet for the same, then that Android manifest file will also will provide the permissions to that APK or the application to use the internet from the mobile itself. So you will get basic information like the SDK version, from which Android version to which Android version this APK will be supported, the permissions. Like remember, when you install any of the APK in your mobile, and that APK will ask about the permissions for the same, and you will tap on the allow or only allow or something like this. So these are the permissions that you are giving to that APK to use to use further. So activities, okay. So you will also get the information about the activities which is used by the APK. I'll tell you what exactly activities are, content providers and intent. I'll tell you in the next slides. Okay, so as I have already mentioned, permissions. But unfortunately, this permissions doesn't have any extension. So it defines the data or the hardware component of that particular Android device, something like camera, internet, access to the external storage, Bluetooth, etc. So like if I give you the example, like if you are going to pay online using Paytm, then you just open the QR scanner, and that QR scanner will ask about your to access the camera. And the moment when you allow that Paytm application to use the camera, the camera will be able to scan that particular QR code, and you are able to pay the particular amount to the shop mem to the shop. Yes. So here you are going to give the permission, and that permission is allow in is mentioned in that Android manifest file. So here so it's so the permission is like you have to provide the allow the permissions to use that particular hardware component of your Android device. Okay, so moving further, activities also do not have any extension to, but activities actual meaning is the UI element of your application or your APK file. Something like if I take an example of Google Pay. So when you open the Google Pay application, the first screen will be show that APK will show you the GPay logo, and the second will ask about your fingerprint, and then third will display all the payment you have did in past. Okay, so like if I talk about this second part, that fingerprint. So fingerprint also asking for the permission of to use that hardware of fingerprint sensors, and then you will be able to log in into that So for that, that GPay will be allow an authentic user to check all the payments you have did in past. So here, the main thing is intent. What exactly intent is? So intent is nothing but changing from one activity to the second activity in that particular APK. So here, if we talk about this first step and the third step, so there is one intent which allow this first screen to jump into the second screen after authenticate to that particular person in that APK. So this is the actual meaning of intent. Moving further, okay. So in static analysis, we will be going to use or find some strings which is present in the resource folder. I'll show you everything. The threat vectors, like where we can find the information in the static analysis, like the login bypass, URL exposed, which may be hard-codedly present, the API key, like the Firebase URL, which is used by the APK. Okay, so before moving further with the dynamic analysis, let's jump to the static, like practical implementation of the static analysis. Just give me a minute. Okay, so to start with the static analysis, there are two ways to do the same. The first one is to use a JDX GUI tool, which is available open source, and you can download it to your respective OS and you will start the same. So what you have to do is just import the APK which you want to scan for the same, and it will extract all the information which is present in that particular APK. I think everyone is able to see my screen. Anubhav, could you please confirm?
Yes, we can.
Okay. Thank you. So in that APK, you will be provide the source code for the same, the resources folder, and the APK signature. Some of the application doesn't have that APK signature, and you will be get some in some of the APK or applications for the same. Okay, so moving further, if we talk about the package name, okay, so for every APK, there is a package name for the same, and you will be display all the package name in when you extract the APK or any of the application. Here, you will be able to see all the files which is present or like available at the time of building any APK. Okay, for to start with the testing, I'll show you one thing. Okay, so to understand better what exactly I'm trying to deliver to you guys. So I'll just testing or try to understand all the logical things with this APK, which is injured Android. And for like I'll be solving all these four flags with the static analysis. And with that, I'll show you each and every logical aspect what exactly I'm doing and how you can proceed for the same. So like for the flag one login, so here it is providing some input field and you have to submit the flag for the same. But what exactly, where you find the flag for for this particular challenge one? So if we hit on this hint button, this hint will be providing the flag is right under your nose. So as if we see in this JDX UI, we have extracted the APK, and if we see the file called flag one login activity, we will open this file, and if we go through the code, this the hint button which is showing here, the code is here. The flag is right under your nose, and the flag is also under the GUI. But if we go to the last, like access modify change from protected, there is a comment mention, okay. And if we go to the last, the final void, submit flag, okay. So there is a method called submit flag, and here if we go to g.a, there are some files which is using or importing the in this flag one login activity. And if we I think this one is the this one is the flag. So if we paste it here, and then okay, so we got the first flag. So what I did is just go to the code, and if there is a hard-coded string present in this particular code, then you will be able to get all the like the information for this particular APK, which is not meant to be exposed at to the public users. So sometimes the information is also provided in this in the code itself. So you have to take care of these thing also, like what which file you seems which is not in the APK, which may be fine, which may include some of the information for the same, like what like we have just did here, flag one. So this string is hard-codedly present and in the text, in the plain text format. So this is how you can find any of the information from the code itself. Okay, so move to the next challenge. So there is called there so there is a hint, there is a way to bypass main activity and invoke the other activity that are okay, the hint is not completed. Okay, so we'll go to the flag two activity, as the activity name is mentioned here. So we'll select the file called flag two activity. Okay, so here you can you will also provide some of the files, like the code for the same. For every challenge there is a code. You all can try with this application to start with the static analysis and do your own research for the same. And there are also other applications provided in open source, so you can use those also. And one more thing, if you are like bug bounty hunter, and if you want to scan for the particular target, then you can also follow these steps and do your research on that particular target, so that you can find any valid bug or valid information for the same. Okay, so this code is same, but there are some changes in the last method, and it is asking for some activity flag too, and okay, so floating action button. Okay, so there are some activity calling for in this method. So we'll do one thing, just log in into that Android APK, and we'll do the rest of the thing. Okay, we are in the Android device, Android shell. If you do something like ADB shell, then you will be able to access into this emulator. Okay, just give me a minute. Okay, so there are lots of questions. I'll clear all the doubts one by one. Sure, in the last of this session. Please write your questions in anywhere, and I'll try to clear each and every one doubt in the last. You are absolutely right, Cyber Geek. I'm using a power mirror to mirror my mobile application screen to my laptop. So it pretty handy to use that Android physical device over the laptop. Okay, for static analysis, the first method I'm using JDX UI, the tool which is available, open source. Okay. Okay, to log in or to connect Android shell, you have to connect first with the ADB command. So ADB is nothing but a software which you have to require to connect any of the Android shell via Android USB cable or via TCP over the TCP connection or TCP network. If your Android version supported that particular TCP network support, then you will be able to connect to the Android shell or Android like Android complete Android architecture. So here, if you run like Android shell, then you will be able to log in into the Android shell. You will be perform all the commands which you usually use in Linux operating system, like ls and okay. So here the user Kali is showing because I have installed NetHunter in that particular Android device. So don't get confused with the same, like you have getting generic cross 86 underscore 64 something like you user here. So it's just about what architecture you are using in that particular Android device. It will show here. And then if you run like who am I command, then you will be get all the user information, like what exactly user is login at that particular time. Okay, so for the second challenge, it is asking for some main activity or some activity sort of thing. So when you log in into that Android shell, you will be able to perform some of the command like pm, which is used for like list all your package managers. So like if you run the command pm list and then packages, so you will be getting all the information of the in app application which is running in that particular Android device. So if you check like com.whatsapp, because I'm using WhatsApp in that particular device, recorder, as I have changed the complete OS, I am using Lineage OS, so that recorder package is also showing. And if we talk about this package, Android com.android.webview, so similarly, if we want to list, or if you want to get the package name of that flag or this APK, this injured APK, then we will be like for that we can just use the grep command and then type injured. So here you will be providing all the information of the package or the package name for that particular APK. And if you want to get the path for the same, like where the base APK is available or installed in this particular Android device, then you will run this command, like pm path, and then provide this particular package name. So here your Android like the APK base path is here, like it will in the root data folder, and then app, then the package name followed by some random strings, and then the base APK. So there are two things, like you can install any of the APK from the Google Play Store, and if you want to do the static analysis, then you have that particular APK. You should have that APK to proceed with the same. So like what you can do is just take the APK backup from somewhere and just download it from like download it to your operating system. And there is a second way which is more convenient to me also, like to get the path of that particular package which is installed in your Android device, to get that data. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry, there is a call. Okay, so to get that particular path, you just run this pm path and the path package for the same for particular APK, and to get the exact path for the same. Now you have to download or extract that particular APK in your operating system to proceed further. So there is again we are going to use ADB command, and here we use ADB pull. So pull is same for what we can say, every services which we are using nowadays, like GitHub. If you use like GitHub pull command, and you will git clone or git pull command, so you will be aware about that particular command, that it will download or it will update particular code from the repository in your local machine. Same goes with the Docker pull command. If you want to pull any of the image you want to use in your machine, then you will run the Docker pull command followed by the pull Docker image name for the same. Similarly, if we talk about Android or ADB, the ADB pull command will pull your base APK from the Android shell, which is present here. Like if you can see here, this is the complete path for the same. Like to get the path, you will run this particular command, and you will be able to get the particular path, and then you will run ADB pull, and then paste your complete path, and then followed by your APK name. So it is in okay. Okay, so it is pulling the APK from the target, and now it is pulled. Okay, as you can see, I have all this injured APK, which the APK which is installed in this particular Android device. Okay, so this is some additional function that I want to share with you. So for starting this particular or to complete the second challenge, we will be going to activate some of the activities to get that particular result or flag for the second challenge. And if we talk about okay, so if we go to the JDX GUI, there is a there's some activities called let's see. Okay. There's a file called Android Manifest. I can't be able to see where the exact file is. Okay, here. So every time if there is a like if there is an issue call issue something like activities or if someone or that AP like application is mentioning activity sort of thing, then always look for the keyword called exported equals true. Here, if we okay, it is loading export or export. No. Okay, so we have to look for the parameter called export equals true. Okay. So here there is one activity which is like so activity is the syntax of this activity is this like followed by anchor bracket and then followed by the activity parameters and then all the required things that may be required at the time of development any of the APK. So if we go so there is one true which is the activity one, and then the other one will go to this one. Okay, so there are only two activities, which is the other one is the theme, but the second one is the activity name itself. So I think this one is our activity name that we have to take to solve our second challenge. Just take this and okay, so here you will start the activity, and for the activity you will be like you have to run the command am and followed by am start and then paste your activity name because in this the exported true parameter only two things are available. The first one is theme, which is not work for us because we have to take the name of that particular activity And the second one, the name is mentioned like BNAC injured Android dot QXV0AA, something like this. So I got an hint like this will be the activity name for the same, and this will give us a flag as expected. So here, if you check this and run the particular command, okay. So when I run this particular command, there are something some activity changed, and if I okay, no, so that activity is not correct. We'll go to the other one. Okay, so here another exported true parameter is there, which is mentioned in this activity rule, and we'll try this activity name. Okay, so we got the second flag. Like it start that particular activity from the external. I want to add one more point. So whenever if you see any of this permission or any of this value in the Android manifest, that means you will be able to, or you can able to access this particular activity from outside the APK. It's like I'm using this activity from outside of this Android device or APK or the application which is running in your device. Like I have connect my Android device to the operating system using the ADB, which is connect outside the Android device, and then I'm able to perform all the commands which may be required or which is required at the time of or to start or to start or to display all the packages which is installed in this particular Android device. So this exported true means like you can use this or you can access this particular service outside the APK or outside the Android device. So here if I select this one, like as I have selected before, and run this command, so it will start the intent. So intent is nothing but it changed from the previous UI display or the previous UI which is showing like that login button to the main activity or the activity which we have called just now. So here we have called this B25AL activity, something like this, from the outside of device or the outside of activity, and it start that particular intent from previous device or previous UI from the next UI which is mentioned here, and it will provide a second flag for the same. So here we have completed our second challenge also. Okay, so we can go to the third flag. Resources R stand for the resources, check for dot XML files. Okay, great. So this APK is giving direct hint to us, like you can use the strings file or the XML file for the same. And for this, you can go to this. Okay. Okay, so for strings or any other files which is in the again XML format, and you will be provided them hard-coded. You can scan or research for the same like on that particular directory. So here there is a folder called RES, and there is a again subfolder called values, and you will be providing all the parameter like all the files which may required or which is required to provide the additional information to that APK or the services which is using by the APK. So if we go to the strings.xml, here you can let me okay. So here you can check all the parameters or all the hard-coded string which is present here, like for any of the APK, like with the strings.xml file. there is a key or the parameter called AWS underscore ID, AWS underscore secret. Although they have not provided that particular data or particular ID for the same, but there so this is the file exact file path you can find, or you can get the details for the same, like all the parameters or all the hard-coded strings which may be required, or which you where you can find actual find the information from this particular directory. Okay, so here if you can see, let's search about flag. Okay, so here is a flag, clear text. Okay, so we got the flag third also. So like it is name as something, and it is providing some strings over there. Okay, there is a another method to find to proceed with the same. So for specifically this challenge, I'm going to the third, the flag three activity. Okay, again the code is same here at the top of this, like for the hint and all part. But if we go to the last method here, you can see file called G. There is a file called A which is present here, A, and here if you can G. So they are using some text edit to get the strings for the same. Okay, so here you will get that particular string which we have find in like that strings.xml. Okay, that string is same for the same. So you can either go with that procedure, or you can go with this procedure. So both are the right ways to get into that particular strings.xml file, or to get the data from that particular strings.xml file. Okay, so if we talk about other files, you will also provide some attributes. If we talk about this boolean, nothing here. So you can also get an idea like what color coding they are using. And if we go to the integer, nothing interesting here. So by this method, by this process, you can actually find the hard-coded strings which may be required or may be present at the time of testing, so that you can go further and report for the same, like you have find some you have find some information which is sensitive to the like to the APK or to the organization or the service which is using by the APK. Okay, so by this we have completed our third challenge. Okay, login for. Where is Bob? Class is an import. Okay, so go with the class four activity. Here, if you can see, okay, the code is again same. I'll just mentioning just for your notice. Okay, so in the last method, there are some again classes are using that GED, and like they have again taking the strings from the classes G and D. But if we okay, so there is a interesting thing is here, like this is odd from these classes. So if we go to this, oh, we got nothing. But okay, let's search about this particular class. Check that if we get something here. Okay, we don't have any file like this. Need to intent this. Let's close these unused files so that we can clearly see what we are doing. Flag one success. I think there is a file. Have to I think this one is taking time to solve this. Let's move further for the dynamic testing, and I'll tell you in the last. Like what exactly the procedure to solve this particular fourth challenge. I think the file is missing in this version of APK. Okay, let's move to the dynamic part. Okay, so for dynamic analysis, like to before starting with the same, like I'll tell you some basic point or the points which you have to take care about. For dynamic testing, you will be doing some changes to a runtime or a running application, and then you will be able to see changes, what exactly changes are reflecting on that particular runtime APK. Okay, so for first, like the introduction to the SSL pinning, what exactly SSL pinning, I'll tell you in the next slide. Just give me a minute. Introduction to the FRIDA and objection. Again, these two are the framework which is like aggressively used when you are doing Android VAPT or iOS VAPT. And dumping the memory and the sensitive data, runtime analysis of the local storage. So these things we will be covering in the next few slides. Okay, so for SSL pinning is nothing but a methodology to ensure or to make a confirm that the traffic will not intercept from the application itself. So some of the application will verify the receiving traffic from the to the APK, which is known as a like known certificate, which is installed in your Android devices or the devices where you are going to perform the testing for the same. And if you try to intercept the network or try to intercept the request which is coming to or from the Android or the APK, like your app may be crash at the same time. So information or all these things will be done when you are trying to add or trying to manipulate or trying to change any of the requests or trying to add this a new certificate. So your at that time your app may be crash or may not be crash. It's depend upon the nature and the situation for that particular time. Okay, so for moving further, root detection, there is one again concept. Like root detection is nothing but it will detect like your APK, like the binary, super user binary. So what exactly the concept behind is, if any application is able to run in any of the rooted device or rooted I mean physical device, then that APK will be able to use all the permission which is required, which is used at for the root user. And APK will be able to run all these like required things from the root user itself. The APK can use the root user permissions for the same in that particular Android device. Like for Android device, the binaries like the binaries which is used for as a super user can be present in one of the following mentioned directories in the slide, like slash system slash bin slash u su I mean sorry x bin and then like the su again. These are the binaries which shows that your Android device is rooted. Moving further, okay, so before going to Q&A, I'll show you the dynamic analysis of this particular. Okay, so to start with the dynamic analysis, you have to you have like a tool which intercept your proxy, and for intercepting any of the tool, the best tool which we always keep in mind is Burp Suite. Let's wait to start this Burp Suite. Okay, for dynamic analysis, I will be showing like how you can like bypass the SSL pinning certificate, how you can bypass the root detection if any of the APK will pop up any of the error or warning sign like this app cannot be run in that particular Android device or the like the changed device or manipulated device, something like the error message which is provided by the developer or the organization itself. So like before jumping into that like before jumping into intercepting the proxies or the other stuff, let's just discuss about some tools which I have mentioned in the slide, which is called Frida and Objection. Okay, so in the previous slide I have mentioned like you can list all the like all the packages which is installed in your Android device. So for the same, like to get the package name from the for the dynamic analysis, you can run or you can use the tool called Frida, which is okay. So Frida and Objection, both tools are from the same organization, I think. As they are worked like they dependent to each other. So to get the package like the package name, you run the command like Frida and followed by hyphen ps and space with hyphen capital UAI, and with that you will be able to get all the package name which is running at that particular time. So here if you can see, I'm not using at that like Magix tool at that particular time. Like the Magix tool is not running in the background. So here, if you get any PID, that is process ID, respective to your package name, then it should be understandable that your application is running in background like this. Like I have using A power mirror. So I think that also showing here. Okay, so the very first application is A power mirror, which has 61531 okay 16531 PID, and it is identified as a package name of this. Okay, so moving further, we got the package name of injured BNAC injured Android. We'll go further, and bypassing any of the SSL certificate or SSL unpinning, you can go with two methods. The first one is from the FIDA from the FIDA tool itself, and the second one is with the objection tool. So I'll tell you first with the FIDA. Yes. Okay. So, for in order to bypass the SSL unpinning, like SSL certificate in any of the device, you have to pass your own. Either you can pass your own script, which bypass the SSL pinning detection, or you can use this great website called FIDA CodeShare, where you can you will be having all the tools, which all the scripts which may or may not be work at to bypass your SSL pinning certificate. Okay, I forgot one thing. I just want to add one thing here. I think my phone got hacked. Okay, so in order to connect with your Android mobile with the ADB, there is one method for the same. Like to enable your developer option, just clicking the seven times that build number in your device, and then you will be able to get this developer option here, and then you have to allow this Android USB debugging. So it will enable all the ADB, that is Android Debug Bridge interface, to your operating system where you have installed your ADB device, and then you will be able to get access, or you can connect to your Android device with the ADB. So here there is one another function called ADB over network. So here you can just select this if you have this functionality in your Android version, and if you don't have any this kind of functionality, then you can use your USB cable, Android USB cable, and then it will be same as this one, like ADB over the network. So I just forgot this procedure before, so I just mentioned here. Okay, so moving further, if we so I was telling the bypassing of SSL certificate or SSL unpinning bypass. So for this, the first one is FIDA, and if we go to the FIDA one, then there is one command called FIDA and followed by the code share. Okay, so here the code share is nothing but the parameter which takes the source code from this particular directory, followed by the hyphen f, and hyphen f is nothing but the package name which you are going to mention, or you are going to put for particular target which you are researching on or doing penetration testing for the same. Okay, it is not finding. Okay, guys, just give me a minute. Think there is some issue with my Frida tool. It is not taking my package name from the my device. Okay, I think there is some issue with the package name. Let's try with the another package. Let's say if I take let's say the Swiggy application. So copy this, and then if we go to this one, Swiggy, this one. Okay. So when I run this command, okay, it is not showing again. Okay, I think my Frida got crash because it is not taking my package name. So I'll tell you the exact procedure. What I'm trying to do is just take that particular package name with on like what exactly in your target for any of the APK. So what you have to do is just take this like CodeShare website where you will provide all the unpinning code scripts which may which is required at for bypassing the SSL certificate for particular application in order to intercept the request which is coming or going from the APK or like whatever the target you are using. So here if you go to this Universal Android SSL pinning bypass with Frida, and if you go with this, you getting a command for the same like Frida and followed by the CodeShare nothing but this particular website where this script will be pulled and followed by the package name the package name of your target or your application on which you are working on. And similarly, if you go with this, you will be you will start a session from the Frida like the to start the process for bypassing the SSL. And then when the moment when you run this command, the application will start automatically and run and try to like get all this script or like all the traffic from the application itself if that script will be able to bypass that particular SSL. So by this you will be able to capture any of the requests. So like if we go to this Swiggy application. Cool. We are able to get the request from the application. So with the Swiggy application, I'm able to capture the request as I have select on retry. I'm getting all the requests and got intercepted over the burp suit. Okay, Frida hyphen script. Thanks, Ajay. Okay. Okay, someone just ping the command for the same. So just start with this. And then by the package name here. I think it will work now. Oh, no, it is not working. Is for the manual script. Try it in new terminal. Okay. But is there any worth to try in new terminal because it is not using any session or something? Will it impact any changes over there? No, my tool is not working. I think it is crashed. Okay, so I think the concept is clear with you all guys, because this is nothing like a rocket science here. You just need to mention the script from the code share or your manual script, as the Anurag has already mentioned. Like for hyphen L, you with that parameter you can pass your manual script for the same for this particular package. And if you don't want to use any manual script, you can go with the code share directory where you have already all the scripts which is available open source, and you have to just mention this particular command and followed by your package, and it will start the process of SSL unpinning bypass. So in order to intercept the request from the application itself. So here, as you all can see, I can able to intercept a request from the application called Swiggy. And if that application may be differ in your situation, in your aspect, like what on which target you are working on. And with that, you can manipulate and you can send it to the repeater and change the parameters, what exactly you want to see the changes, which may be unusual when it comes from the server or in the response tag, and you will be able to get an idea of what exactly happening in this particular request. For an example, like request call get, and there is a file path where some request is calling from this particular path. I'm sorry, file, not a file path, it's a path where the request is calling. So, and the host is also mentioned. So you can do the changes according to your understanding and send it to the response, and you will get the information what exactly getting from that particular request. So it's a complete process of how you can bypass the SSL pinning certificate. So the next method is with the objection. So for objection, you can run the command like objection and then followed with hyphen g to mention the package name for which you are going to do the research on, and then pass the parameter called explore, and it will restart the application. As you can see, the package name on Xiaomi 9, which is my physical device, is connected now. So here you can check perform all the possible commands or possible functions which is again provided by the objection framework. So like when you type Android, it will suggest you like the possible commands which you want to run for the same, like SSL pinning. Okay, so there is a functionality called you can directly bypass the SSL pinning certificate from the objection itself. So like there is a function again called disable, and then you can use quite, so it will disable your SSL certificate. Okay, I think the process is done now. And as we already have as we have already seen here, like we are able to get this particular request from the application. Okay, so there is one point, like some of the companies might not take it as a serious vulnerability, but some of them are taking as a serious vulnerability because it is somehow changing, or you can edit or manipulate other requests for the same, and to get the additional detail or additional things which is coming back to as a response tab. So some of them take it as a medium level, some of them take it as a high level, some of them taking as a low level as per their requirement of for that particular organization. Okay, so moving forward with the objection, there is also one functionality with this framework called you can like bypass the root detection also. So for Android, again type Android root, and then you there is a again option called disable. So I think this application is not popping up any of the warning, like you can't use any of the like you can't use Swiggy or you can't use this application on rooted device. But some of the application might you can face this issue, like whenever you install any of the application in the rooted device, and the moment when you start the application, that application will pop up a warning call, you can't be able to proceed further or can't be able to proceed to the next like the activity you are going to show for that particular APK, because you are running that APK in the rooted device. So for that you have to bypass the root root detection for that particular APK. And again, there is a tool called objection. You can go with this and run the particular command like Android root disable, and with that you can able to do that. So there is this is the first. And the second thing is, you can go with the Firefox, I'm sorry, you can go with the Frida again. And if you see here, there are also okay, there are also script which present for the root detection bypass. So here is the one, and as my Frida is already crashed, so I can't be able to show this one, but this process is same. Like you have to pass the code which is coming from the code share repository, or you can pass your own manual script and followed by your package name. So it will, it may be bypass that root detection, and there are many things to bypass root detection or SSL thinning. And the third one I want to share as an additional information, like you can use some modules from exposed as ed expose installer. So this is a framework, we can say, or a application which provide you some modules for the same. Like if we talk about SSL unpinning module, so currently it is not installed in my device. So I'll tell you the exact view of this particular application. Like this SSL unpinning point 2.0 will be installed from the expose installer, ed expose installer, and then you will be see all the list of installed application. As I've already unpinned this injured Android application, so it might be possible that this SSL unpinning application or module will bypass that SSL certificate with this particular application. So we have to try multiple things, which method will work as a like the vulnerability or the bug for this particular application or any of the target you are going to research for the same. Okay. I think I have covered. Okay, there is another command called you can check the memories also, which is using at the particular time of like when the application is running. Okay, so you can dump all the memory which is using by this by the application. In my case, the application is Swiggy.android, which is running on Xiaomi again. So if I hit this command, okay, so local destination, I'll try to capture this. Okay. Okay, like for I think my there's some problem with this framework. I'm not getting any memory term. Okay, so you can connect to the database, local database, which is again present in the directory of the EPK or the like package directory. As you can see here, there is also a DB file, which is again a SQLite file. You can also check this. If any of the data, if any of the EPK is using some runtime data in this particular particular session, or we can say. So if any of the data is storing on that, and that data will be in the plain text format, then you will be able to get the details from there also. So again, that SQL file will also available, or .db file will also available in that particular directory or the package. So from where you can just pull that particular file and check it in any of the tool or tool where you can get the data from that particular DB file. And if we okay, I think I have completed all the tools. Okay, so like for with this command jobs list, so it is nothing but it's showing you the possible jobs, which is again hit with the objection to that particular package name. Let's say in my case, the package name or the application is Swiggy. So it is showing like these two jobs are running for that particular package or the application. So if you are hitting multiple jobs, then you will be able to see all these job list in your scenario in your case. So like if you are dumping the memory, if you are any like using any other attack or other process for the same, like you will be showing all the job list for the same. So okay, think I have completed. Okay. Okay, it's time for Q&A. So,
Yeah,
Anubhav.
if you have any question, then please you can type on the chat, or you can raise your hand. I will unmute you.
Anurag, I did the same. Like I have connected with the IP followed by the port, but it is not working. It seems like my Frida is crashing. If anyone have any questions, then please ask.
You can also raise your hand if you want. I will try to unmute. Sir, they are asking about, can you tell about this memory dump?
Oh, I'm so sorry. I was on mute. Okay, for memory dump is like the memory which is using with the with that particular APK at the runtime. It's a snapshot of like the memory which is with the memory part or the memory chunk we can say for that particular APK. And this memory format which is stored in the binary format, like I can't be able to show exact the binary sorry memory dump for this particular APK. Let me I think it is dumping somewhere, but I can't be able to show.
Sir, I think they are asking about what is memory dump like that means. I think. Can you tell about this memory dump?
Okay. I just okay. So memory dump is nothing but it's a like the part of the memory which is used by the application which may you get like the activities or the fragments like all the leak information from one activity to the another. And it is again in the binary format. So there are again some other rules for to get the information from these leaks. And so basically it's nothing but like it take your some part of the memory which is again used by the application and which may leak some of the information from one activity to another or the fragments of that particular memory or the heap we can say. I think I am able to clear that out. Can you take a session on iOS pen testing? Definitely, definitely. For iOS pen testing will require the Apple products. Whenever I have the those devices, then I'll definitely plan for the same. How to unlock bootloader in physical device? Okay, so for bootloader, you can go in the settings, in the developer option. Okay. In the developer option, you have one function called OEM. I think there is some option to check that OEM bootloader, and then you will be able to unboot like unlock that bootloader option for any of the device. Yes, Anurag, we can use Magic's application to unroot the device. Like for that, first you have to like take like flash your TWRP recovery for a particular brand, and then you will be able to flash that particular Magix application, and then you will be able to root that Android device. Not be able to unlock bootloader. Anurag, if you can tell what device you are using, then it would be great for me also. Okay. I think Vivo has provided some additional tools from their organization, like from official, to unlock the OEM bootloader for that particular device. Because with the MI, they have provided some additional tool to unlock that OEM function in that particular device. So I think Vivo also have some tools for the same, like to unlock that bootloader, OEM bootloader. Any other questions? For flashing DWRP, we need to unlock. Yes, Anurag, the same. Okay. Okay, so as I already mentioned, there are some tools which, like from the Vivo itself, they provide to unlock your OEM bootloader for the same. Just search for any specific tool which is available from the Vivo, which is help to unlock your bootloader. Okay, the Windows. I'm sorry, I just can't be able to pronounce the name. And he is asking like how to export this memory dump. I have just mentioned the command like a memory dump all, but somehow my tool is crashing, so I can't be able to get the memory dump for this particular package name. So this is the command. When you the moment when you just connect with this particular package, I'll show you again. Okay, so the moment when you run this command, you will be able to get with this package name or the application. I think it is again crashing. Okay. Okay, so we have connected, and the moment when you run memory dump, and then like from the base application or to the entire memory for this current process, and then you run this command, and you will be able to dump all the memory files or all the memory information. But somehow this application in my laptop, it is not dumping the information in the local destination. So this is the exact like way to dump all the memory from this particular AP. Yes, Vittu, developer mode OEM enable smartphone install TWRP install Magix using TWRP. Yes. Anurag, you can try this this method, like to enable or disable the OEM on bootloader. If you find any new technique or tool to unlock bootloader of new, then please. Sure, Anurag, I will definitely share. Yes, I'll share this PPT. Anubhav,
Yes, sir. Sir, there was also
sorry. Please, please, please forward.
Cyber Geek was asking what are the steps to identify the mobile attack vector before performing the dynamic analysis?
Okay, so dynamic vectors, if we talk about dynamic analysis, the first one, we will intercept the issue as an issue. Like, you can't be able to intercept the request from the APK. So you trying to bypass that SSL unpinning thing. Next, if you are using that APK in the rooted device, then APK must be showing some warning or some message that you can't run that APK into that rooted device. So your next vector will be to bypass that root detection process. Then you, if you are able to bypass all those two things, then you will be able to get you will be able to intercept all the requests from the APK. Then most of the time, APK will always call the API endpoints. Then you will be getting all the endpoints, API endpoints from the APK itself. Then you try it again, if APK is vulnerable to SQL injection or something like this, then you will going to see all the API endpoints and then perform all the valid stuff over there. So in order to check all what response you are getting after manipulating any of the requests, which is confirming or which is receiving from the API itself, API endpoint. So by this, you can check or you can go with each and every endpoint. What if that endpoint is vulnerable for any specific webs, sorry, for a specific vulnerability. Okay, so coming to the next. Can we root using Frida manually? I didn't get the question. Can we root? What exactly you want to root? Because for device, you can't be able to root with Frida. I'm unable to catch up on any. I missed too much. We are recording. Akshit, it will be available on OWASP DKT YouTube channel.
Yes, yes, it will be available soon. Also, the PPTs will be shared on speaker desk. Be connected to our OWASP DKT Twitter handle. We will tweet about the recordings and all. This
can
is,
we
I
root
have shared the link of OWASP DKT Twitter handle. You can follow it for updates.
Okay, can we root Android manually? Can we root Android? We have to root it manually because there is no automation for the same. Like, you have to go in the fast boot option of your device, and then you have to done the other sort of stuff like flashing your TWRP image which is dependent to your device, and then you have to follow the other things. Ritvik Rajiv, can you please show Project Nightingale for Android PT? Ritvik, I think it is not related to this talk. I'll definitely show on the other session someday. We can't root using Frida. We can only bypass root detection using Frida. We can use manual script also. Exactly, Anurag, you are right. We can't be able to root any of the Android device, but we are able to, or we can bypass root detection if any of the application will face any of the pop-up or any messages when that application will run on Android device. Or you can, yes, you can use a manual script also. Thanks, Pramod. So you can check out the link which Pramod shared. So this is the YouTube channel of OWASP DKTE. Okay, Ajay have shared something informational. So if any of the device bootloader is can't be able to unlock, then you can just mail to that particular company the phone itself, like the company of your phone, and they will provide you the other useful information further. Thanks, Ajay. Any other questions? Sure, I'll share some more resources with the PPT itself.
Any other questions, guys? I think no questions are there.
Okay.
Pramod, can you please take the next?
Thank you, sir, for the great session, and I hope everyone likes it. And this session will be uploaded in our YouTube channel. So please subscribe our channel. And yeah, thank you.
Thank you, everyone, for joining and for your weekend time. I hope you have learned something new and something interesting today. So, bye bye.
Okay, guys, thank you. For attending.
Thank you.
We will meet in our next session, which will be soon in next month only, January. So, okay, guys, then bye bye.